At the Gestational Diabetic, I am here to inform you and empower you so that you can be a confident member of your healthcare team. Today, we are talking about what is gestational diabetes, and I hope to answer all of your questions because even after we give the definition, a lot of times there seem to be a lot of questions that still need to give a little more clarity about just what exactly gestational diabetes is. So hopefully by the end of this video, you'll be able to know exactly what it is and what it is not. So gestational diabetes is also known as gestational diabetes mellitus. It's GD or GDM for short. And what it is high blood sugar that is recognized and diagnosed in pregnancy. Gestational diabetes is during the gestation period, gestation being pregnancy. So gestational diabetes can only be diagnosed in pregnancy. If you are not pregnant, there is no way you can possibly have gestational diabetes. So that being said, gestational diabetes also ends when the pregnancy ends. After your pregnancy is over, you no longer have gestational diabetes. If you continue to have high blood sugar, you might be diagnosed as pre-diabetic or type 2 diabetic. And I'll get into what that is in a second. There's still a lot that we don't know about gestational diabetes. It's kind of this phenomenon that we don't understand just exactly how it starts. All we know is that during pregnancy, we have a lot of hormonal changes going on, and that sometimes affects our insulin and how it's being passed through the placenta and how the baby is adjusting to everything that's going on inside of your body. So I want to let you know that just because you get diagnosed with gestational diabetes, it does not mean that you did anything wrong. It doesn't mean that you were unhealthy or that you were indulging or doing something that you shouldn't have been doing or not doing something that you should have been doing. Nothing like that. Sometimes it's just a simple case of there are so many hormonal changes in your body and your body is adjusting, and this is where it might be lacking, but it's nothing that you need to take guilt in. We have to relieve ourselves of the guilt that we feel when we get diagnosed, because a study showed that 40% of women with gestational diabetes had no risk factors at all. Okay, so that's why I say it's a phenomenon. We still don't know a lot about it, and some things just cannot be explained as to why higher blood sugars are happening. Also, just because you have gestational diabetes does not mean that you're not healthy. You could be a runner, you could be a gluten-free eater, you could be a vegetarian, or whatever you consider your version of healthy to be, and you can still develop gestational diabetes, because it doesn't matter who you are, what you're doing, how you're living your life. Again, it is hormonal changes due to pregnancy that produces this condition sometimes. So no one can say that you were living unhealthy before. As a matter of fact, because you are being diagnosed as a gestational diabetic in pregnancy, we cannot tell if you were pre-diabetic before pregnancy or if you had type 2 diabetes before pregnancy. That right now, that question lingering in the mind is just water under the bridge, and it makes no difference. So right now, the important thing is to treat your gestational diabetes and, if necessary, make lifestyle changes so that it doesn't turn into type 2 diabetes after pregnancy. So let's talk about what pre-diabetes is. If you are diagnosed as a pre-diabetic, that means that you are having high blood sugars that aren't high enough to be diagnosed as type 2 diabetes. Also, pre-diabetes means that it is very likely that within 5 years, you will go on to develop type 2 diabetes if you don't make the necessary lifestyle changes to prevent yourself from developing type 2. When I say lifestyle changes, I'm talking about making changes to your diet and being more active, adding more exercise into your regimen. Okay, so pre-diabetes is not gestational diabetes. Why? Because it's not in pregnancy. You cannot be diagnosed with pre-diabetes in pregnancy. If you are having elevated blood sugars in pregnancy, it will always be diagnosed as gestational diabetes until maybe we get further advanced in our knowledge of what gestational diabetes is and how it occurs. Okay, type 1 diabetes is a different case altogether. Type 1 diabetes is an autoimmune disease. When you have an autoimmune disease, your body literally attacks itself. So with type 1 diabetes, your body is attacking the cells that produce your insulin. Type 2 diabetes is when you are not producing enough insulin or when the insulin that you produce is not working properly. And insulin is what helps bring our blood sugar down to safe levels. It's the same thing that's happening in gestational diabetes. But again, because you are pregnant, it is diagnosed as gestational diabetes and not type 2 diabetes. If you continue to have high blood sugars after your pregnancy has ended, then you can get tested and be diagnosed with type 2 diabetes. So to recap, gestational diabetes can only be diagnosed in pregnancy. It is the only diabetes that can be diagnosed in pregnancy. And gestational diabetes ends when the pregnancy ends. If you continue to have high blood sugar after pregnancy, it is diagnosed as type 2 diabetes. I hope I was able to answer every single question that you had about what gestational diabetes is and isn't. If you still have questions, you can go to the article that I'm linking in the notes and scroll down to the very bottom and ask those questions in the comments section. Also in the notes section, you'll find a link to the featured recipe. It is by far my favorite recipe on the blog. It is low glycemic because it's a cookie made with honey instead of sugar. And it is so good, you guys. It is a brownie cookie. So it's a cross between a brownie and a cookie. And it's just perfect, really. It's fudgy and chewy, and you can hold it in your hand without getting all sticky and gooey and stuff. You have to try them. So be sure to check that link out too. Okay, guys, and all I have to ask is that if this helped you, be sure to share it with other pregnant moms. Like this video and subscribe to the channel. We want to make sure that the word gets out about this because there's not enough awareness about gestational diabetes. I'm a living testament. I had no idea what it was until it was time to take the test. That's just how it is sometimes. So just be sure that you guys help me get this word out. Share this as much as you can. Share it with anyone who you know who is pregnant or trying to get pregnant so that they can know and be aware, be informed, and again, be a competent member of their own healthcare team.
Quick medical disclaimer, none of the information on this podcast can be used to diagnose or treat any medical condition. If you have a concern for diabetes or you believe you're experiencing symptoms of diabetes, you should go talk to your doctor and get tested. And if you are pregnant and you're in your first trimester, you should ask to be tested for your HbA1c to determine if you already are experiencing high blood sugar. Because the earlier on you're diagnosed, or excuse me, even the earlier on that your higher blood sugars are caught, the better case you're in to be able to manage those early on. And this episode and all of the resources mentioned in this episode can be found at thegestationaldiabetic.com/1, the number 1. Thanks, guys. I'll talk to you next time.